Welcome again to another edition of Houseplants Live. This is the first of the year, and it's actually number 6 in total. And we're doing this at Studio Piso Shed. Again, this is a studio basically here for recording podcasts or videocasts like this. If you want to record a videocast or podcast yourself, you might want to hit the link in the comments. I'll drop it there. I'll tell you some stuff later on about the things coming up this year, but now let's kick it off with Black Loops and Higher.
Steve, we're gonna go with drugs.
This is LeBaron James with Party Starter. Kind of a nice, well, indeed a party starter.
Name something that's a guaranteed party starter.
Music.
Name something that's a guaranteed party starter.
Steve, we're gonna go with drugs.
Name something that's a guaranteed party starter.
This is Tio Cotis. He had a huge hit last year, and this is Clear. I'm loving this already.
Practice.
understand me. But it's easy to talk about. It's easy to sum it up when you just talk about practice. We sitting here, not a game. We talking about practice.
Okay, so yeah, in the new year, I'd like to, it's one of my things I want to do this year, is rant a bit more about stuff. And first thing I want to rant about is, end of last year, we had kind of like a beef between Camel Fat and Seth Troxler. And it kind of got me thinking because Seth Troxler was saying that Camel Fat was basically EDM disguised as tech house, where everybody kind of like fell over and went on, didn't really like what Seth Troxler said and the whole discussion about underground and commercial music lived up again. And I just want to get my two cents about this because it's been bugging me all the time. So first of all, I would like to say that there's not a big pull. Like one pull is commercial music and the other one is underground. I'll come to that later, but I kind of want to give it another name. It's kind of like underground against upper ground, or maybe it's just highbrow for lowbrow. Let's say highbrow music is a bit more developed for the active listener, for the active guy who is actively searching for music and knows his history and knows where tracks come from. And maybe lowbrow is a bit more mainstream for everybody that just like tunes. Well, I think there's one thing you gotta understand, is the one cannot exist without the other. It's kind of like light and dark. You can't say something is highbrow without having something that is lowbrow. So my two cents is that both of them have their force and their advantages. It's when for me something too highbrow is bad and something too lowbrow is bad. There are like disadvantages or things that are not good about this. I would say highbrow is so developed for the active participator in music that it's also very restricted. So it can kind of kill the creative vibe, and it's sometimes, if it's like really restricted, you see that in some scenes the music kind of is the victim, and it's not always the good music that comes with really out of a really restricted scene. So that's what I think is not so good as the music maker. I'm trying to explain this as clear as I can in my bad English. It's this second title of the show is House Music and Stuttering Mike. But on the other hand, lowbrow is kind of like, the bad thing about it is that, you know, you have your opportunistic producers and they make music and kind of steal from others or make covers or whatever. And it's not always, you know, because it's not restricted, because there's not a scene in it, it's more like basically made to make people smile and have a good time. But sometimes it can be a bit opportunistic. So the quality also could suffer. But I'd say on the good side of highbrow is that, you know, when you go out, you kind of know when you're with the kind of the people that are going to a party as well. You kind of know which crowd it is. You kind of feel more connected maybe, whereas lowbrow can be a bit more random. But on the other hand, lowbrow music is more just for music that makes you feel good, and isn't that just what music is supposed to do? So that's my two cents. Now, coming back to the commerciality, both styles, or both, let's say, opposites, are commercial. There's no, like, highbrow is not less commercial. It's both equally commercial. The whole route and the whole marketing trick around it is different, but it's commercial. Let's not get it twisted. There are loads of underground DJs who make tons of more money than supposedly commercial DJs. So it's both really commercial, both make money. If it's not commercial, valid, or viable, or how do you say it, then, you know, those DJs won't exist in a while. And if they do, they make money off it. That's basically why they are DJs and why they have a big name. So the thing that I want to talk about is what I really, really hate is when people from, let's say, the highbrow part of town look down on the people of lowbrow part of town. You're not special or better in music if you like highbrow music more than lowbrow. You're not a better person or whatever. So shut the fuck up and check your ego at the door. Also, when you're a producer, you know that other people make music and it's their passion and they want to live from it as well. Leave them the fuck alone. And you know, the most boring thing is when a supposedly underground DJ is trying to have a take on EDM. It's so fucking boring, and you're not a fucking 14-year-old. So yeah, shut the fuck up. So that's my rant. So there we go. Ellie Escobar with Rhythm now, further on, and I'll promise not to be so angry anymore the next part of this episode. Obviously, if you disagree with me, which I can totally understand, leave a comment, and I'm dying to know what you think about it. All right.
Addicted to the rhythm. The rhythm. The rhythm. Addicted to the rhythm. Addicted to the rhythm. Addicted to the rhythm. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Dombreski with Trust the Process. Fucking nice tune. Love Dombreski's stuff. Really good producer. As you can hear.
Just be yourself.
This is Metro Plane with Be Where I Am. Started playing this tune and the producer guy Arna immediately started yawning, so I don't know if that's a good sign or a bad sign. I think he just had a rough weekend. I think that's it. This is a Yuxek with Go Fuck Yourself. Yeah, it's the title of the song. Can't make anything better out of it. Yeah, man, shout out to Yuxek. He's been doing a damn thing for a hot minute. Props to him. Always love his productions. So with one of my favorite producers of last year, Niall Young, I'm going to leave you this. Buffy Rizzuti, this track is called. Wow, amazing. Yeah, if you're still watching, you're still fucking awesome. Like I always say, we're still developing this. So if you have any comments, questions, remarks or whatever, please leave a comment or mail me or whatever. And we'll look into it, obviously, and hope to see you next time. And yeah, have a good new year. See you soon.